switching teams. It doesn't happen that often in politics, especially when you work in the White House. But our next guest went from walking the halls of 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue with then-President George W. Bush as one of his cabinet secretaries to, in the last few days, announcing his support for the Democratic nominee for President, Hillary Clinton. It's a remarkable move for a man who has been, up until now, a lifelong Republican. But he says Donald Trump has just pushed him too far. Former Commerce Secretary Carlos Gutierrez is here. Thanks so much for being here.
Pleasure.
Appreciate it. So Hillary Clinton, she is a pretty liberal Democrat. How did you come to this decision?
Well, I made the decision not to support Trump during that infamous week where he combined the comments about the Mexican judge, Curiel, and then when he said, my African-American, at his rally. That, for me, was the end of it. I don't want to go back 50 years. I don't want to see kids being bullied at school because they have a Spanish last name. I don't want people talking about my African-American. I don't want people making fun of handicapped people. So I have a decision to make. I have two resumes in front of me. Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton. I'm going with this one, Hillary Clinton. It is a lot better for the country. It is less risky. I think a Trump presidency, in spite of the fact that he's a Republican, is dangerous. And I think it's time to think about the country over party.
Let me ask you, there are a lot of Republicans, obviously, who don't think highly of Hillary Clinton's ethics or her honesty or her trustworthiness. Is any of this an issue for you?
Well, obviously, the whole thing is a consideration, and I had to look at the totality of the picture. I have one resume here for Donald Trump. I have one resume here for Hillary Clinton. And I've chosen this resume. I think this person, Hillary Clinton, is the best for the country. I'm not thinking about a Republican. I'm thinking about a U.S. citizen. I think at some point you have to put the party aside and say, what's best for the country? I don't want to live in a society that I think Donald Trump will create.
So you were a Jeb guy. You worked for George W. Bush. Did you let them know, hey, I'm going to
endorse... I sent emails out.
You sent emails out.
No.
Did they write back? Did they respond?
No.
You know, it's weird. I haven't heard from George W. Bush, Jeb Bush, George H.W. Bush, or any of their spouses, who are certainly all strong women in their own right, about who they're going to vote for.
Yeah. I think that, you know, that's one option is to not vote. And that's an option I had. But I think that's letting ourselves off the hook. And I actually think that Hillary Clinton has the experience. She's been around. She knows how the system works. I think she'd make a darn good president. I would have preferred Jeb Bush.
You would have preferred Jeb Bush.
But I think Hillary is a great choice. I am afraid of what Donald Trump would do to this country.
What are you afraid of? What do you mean? Other than...
Look, first of all, I mean, the economy is important to me. His plan, I love the tax cuts. I'm a Republican. But then he has this sort of import substitution strategy, which is a strategy like an underdeveloped country. Very poor countries think that way. We have to substitute our imports. That would be a disaster, especially if you cut taxes.
So Hillary Clinton, you think, would be better for the economy?
I think so. I think that one thing that Clinton's learned during President Clinton's time in office is budget deficits hinder growth. And that's what President Clinton did in the second term, is cut the deficit, and that drove the growth. She's learned from that. I'm sure she knows that.
You're the former... go ahead.
The other thing, too, is just the kind of society that we will create. I heard the other day, as you know, that David Duke is running for Congress in Louisiana.
Yeah, he's running for Senate.
All right, and he's running for Senate. And he's under Trump's platform. Is that a trend? Are we going to see more of that? Is that the kind of society we're going to be? Are we going back 50 years? I don't want to go back 50 years.
I can already anticipate what Mr. Trump will say about it. He'll say, you're the former CEO of Kellogg, former Commerce Secretary. Your company helps multinationals gain market entry. You sit on the boards of Occidental, MetLife, Time Warner. You're part of the global elite.
I am a proud free enterprise guy. And I believe in trade. And I believe in free enterprise. Hey, Secretary Clinton talked a lot about, in her economic speech, a lot about new business formation. That's the core of our growth, new businesses. Microsoft was once a new business, and it became a large business. Most new jobs come from new businesses. Those are concepts that you may say, well, it's kind of obvious. I haven't heard an economic concept come out of Trump's mouth except for protectionism and lower taxes. You put those two together, that is a recipe for disaster.
What are you hearing from other people in the global elite, if you'll pardon the expression? Because usually they vote Republican. They were proud supporters of Mitt Romney, proud supporters of George W. Bush, proud supporters of John McCain. Where are your fellow CEO types in this election?
Most of them are totally disgusted.
By
the Trump nomination. They don't know what to do. So, as you said, you know, there is this relationship with the Clintons, the Republicans and Clintons, and it hasn't been great. And so they're reluctant to support Secretary Clinton, but they're not going to vote for Donald Trump. And I think that will be a big problem for the Trump campaign. But, Jake, this is a time to think about the country and even think about the party. If Trump wins, I think it's a tactical victory for him and a strategic loss for the GOP. And this is the time to stand up and be and show some leadership.
Where does the Republican, if Trump does not win in November, where does the Republican Party go from there? Will you help rebuild it?
See, yes, of course, I'm still a Republican. And I think that's an interesting way of thinking about it, is this the message the wake-up call that we need to reassess who we are as a party?
But isn't your party, aren't your party leaders out of step with the voters? So they don't like these trade deals that you've pushed for.
Well, trade deals have traditionally been, supported by Republicans. And I think it's a mistake. I mean, this is one thing where I'm not in agreement with either of the two candidates. I think TPP is necessary. Asia's being created into a trade bloc, and unless we have TPP, a lot of our companies will be locked out. Not today, but 5-10 years from now.
So you're supporting Hillary Clinton, even though you have different views on trade?
I don't
she voted agree. Against you. Negotiated CAFTA.
I don't agree 100% with anyone, but I believe Hillary Clinton will make a good president, and I'm going to support Hillary Clinton, and I'm going to do everything possible to make sure that the GOP doesn't get destroyed.
Former Commerce Secretary Carlos Gutierrez, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it.